Hi everyone, thank you for joining our session today on extending iTwin.js applications. My name is Caleb Schaefer, and I'm the development manager for iTwin.js, our open source library for building digital twin applications. I'm joined today by Arun George, one of our lead software engineers on the iTwin.js team that's working to make it better and easier for you to use. In this talk today, we're going to discuss two specific ways of extending iTwin.js applications and how they can help you accelerate your journey to building your own digital twin application. Today, you'll hear in many of the other sessions about all of the great iTwin platform APIs and all the great things you can build with them. And what we want to cover in this session is how you can take those iTwin platform APIs and iTwin.js and extend the iTwin viewer to provide all of that capability to your end users. And this will allow you to try to maximize the benefit you get while tapping into the existing iTwin.js ecosystem using the extensions that already exist. With the extensions that already exist, we provide many out of the box, as I mentioned, for using our iTwin platform APIs and other functionality to go into the viewer. And with an open source mindset, those are all available on GitHub for you to use today. This will help you accelerate your time to building your application. That way you can focus on the things that are unique to you and provide the most value to your end users. Now, talking about the things that are unique to you, building extensions is a great way for you to then contribute back to that iTwin ecosystem and really show people all of the great things you've built and allow them to leverage it in their applications as well. Now, I mentioned two different ways of extending iTwin.js-based applications, and I want to dig into some more details there. Earlier today, Bill and Roop did a session on the different components of the iTwin viewer and how it's built up. I don't want to duplicate what they'd already talked about, so I would encourage you to go check out their session to get more details on the high-level concepts I'm going to talk about here. The first way that we'll talk about extending an iTwin.js application is in a UI agnostic fashion. Now, this one is provides the maximum amount of reuse you'll get out of the functionality you build, since it won't rely on the UI around it, and frameworks such as React, Angular, Vue, Svelte, and any others that will come up in the future, it future-proofs you from having to rebuild this, plus it allows you to take it from application to application without having to worry about whether or not that UI framework will be there. The way this all works is the iTwin viewer at its core is just HTML and vanilla JavaScript. So it doesn't need all of these UI frameworks to build things, and you'll still be able to query your iTwin and iModel data, manipulate the view, and overlay a lot of that information within the iTwin viewer and your application without relying on those frameworks. Now, the second way to do that is all about the UI. And specifically our App UI framework. App UI is powered by React and built using our iTwin UI design system. And App UI is built to be modular and very extensible, so it fits all of the needs that your iTwin.js application may need. Now, since it is written in React, you can add your own React components in widgets and in the panels and many other ways to show that rich information that you're trying to bring to your end user. It allows you to pull in things such as trees, graphs, tables, and grids to really provide all of that data in addition to the 3D model that the iTwin viewer shows. A little bit later, Arun is going to go into an example of how to take both of these methods, the UI agnostic and the one with App UI, bring those together and use a whole bunch of extensions that are either already in the iTwin.js ecosystem or that you build yourself to build your rich and powerful digital twin application. Now, without further ado, I'm going to hand it over to Arun to dive into those details and show you how this all works within a few different iTwin.js applications.
Thanks, Caleb. Hey everyone, I'm Arun. I'm one of the lead developers of iTwin Viewer. I can't wait to show you how you can get started with extending your iTwin.js based application. So as mentioned previously, the fast way for you to get started writing your own viewer based application is to use our iTwin Web Viewer Create React App template. I've actually bootstrapped the new app using the same template, and you can see it here. So you can see you get so much for free right out of the gate, right? You get some navigation tools to zoom around and pan around in the model. You get some sectioning tools to clip parts of the model that interest you, so create some measurements. But also on the bottom, you get the status bar with a mesh center, a tool assistance. And on the right-hand side, you see this panel for widgets such as our tree widget here, which has our models and categories tree. So here in our models tree, it shows you what your iModel is being built of. And the categories, same thing, a different grouping, but you can actually toggle on and off parts of the model that you care about, you don't care about, right? And this is all being driven by the powerful display and presentation system that Bill had mentioned to you earlier. So as you can see, very powerful right out of the gate. And there's so much functionality you could customize and add into this viewer. So let's take a look at how we do so. So here's that iTwin viewer React component that comes with our template. So we have this viewer component, and there's a lot of props you can see that are exposed and to customize your viewer, but I want to emphasize the UI providers prop. So our iTwin viewer is being built using our design system called App UI framework. This is how we lay out our toolbars, our status bar items, and our widgets, and how they kind of interact with each other. So right out of our template, you get all these UI providers for free. And these UI providers all implement a simple interface, which is this interface right here, which this interface pretty much describes what to add to the viewer and where to add it. So all these providers are what builds up the viewer you just saw a few seconds ago with our measurement tools, our sectioning tools and navigation tools and the widgets and all that good stuff. And this is what comes out of the gate, like I mentioned earlier, but let's come in and add our own provider. So here I've actually written I'm going to add two providers, one that I've written. It's this background map toggle provider. So let's take a look at this. This toggle provider is going to be added to our status bar. And it's just going to have an icon for a map. And when you click on this map icon, it's actually just going to just toggle on and off the display from the background map. So just messing with that display system that we've been talking about all day. So let's take a look at our viewer and see what happened. If you look at that, wow. All right, so we have this new icon in the bottom of our status bar, which allows us to toggle on and off our maps. So this is very simple and just a very naive example of what can be done. I've also added a second provider, and I'm not sure if you paid attention to it, but it was the GeoTools search address provider. So this allows you to do a search, like if you're Google Maps per se. So let's go say hi to my good friend Caleb back at the other presentation center. And hey, Caleb, he's somewhere around there. But yeah, as you can see, with just a few short lines of code, we were able to add so much functionality to our viewer. And this is just the beginning. And you're probably wondering, where did I get that second provider from, right? So let's take a look at where this is coming from. And all right, so this is coming from a package called GeoTools React. And that's actually coming from this repo we call Viewer Components React. This is a ever-growing list of UI providers and React components that we expose for you guys to consume very easily into your application with just a few single lines of code. So with this, you're able to augment your viewer with lots of functionalities. Take a look at this repository. And if you'd like to create your own UI provider, I recommend you guys take a look at our tutorials here. We have a nice little walkthrough to customizing different, creating your own items for the toolbar, for the status bar and the widgets. And I also recommend you guys take a look at our sample showcase. So here it was shown earlier today, but we have plenty of samples built using the iTwin platform APIs, but also just using the core iTwin.js APIs. And here we have an example, one of my favorites actually, the car particle effect sample, which you can see all these vehicles moving in real time, right? So this is actually just using the UI provider that we were just talking about earlier. So this is using the car decoration widget provider, and you can actually copy this into your application. So take a look at these samples and be inspired. So yeah, there's your viewer React component, which has that one prop that allows you to augment your viewer very easily. And you've probably noticed by now, we're very invested in React. We are chosen React to be our UI framework of choice, but maybe that's not yours, right? Maybe that's not your forte. Let's say you rather write in Angular or Svelte or Vue or just plain old vanilla JavaScript, right? And also, let's say you have your own design system and you'd rather customize your viewer to be fit in the look and feel of your design system. So how can you go about extending the viewer? And don't worry, we've got you covered. Let's take a look at that. So earlier, Bill had shown you an example of a very basic TypeScript viewer. So like mentioned earlier, it's just iTwin.js APIs and working. It's just JavaScript and HTML at the end of the day, right? So we have this very simple viewer written in TypeScript, just initializes all the things you need, connects to your model, and actually renders it on the DOM using just very basic JavaScript like DOM APIs. So I've actually chosen to write a quick sample using Svelte, and I've actually copied a lot of the code, same code from the TypeScript viewer into the Svelte viewer. So very, very, very similar, but the only difference is just how I'm rendering the UI portion. So not a big deal, right? But let's take a look at that viewer I'm talking about. So here it is. And as you can see, I've actually added a new tool at the top, this select tool. So if I wanted to, I could actually console log out the properties of elements I'm selecting, because I don't have a property grid here. But let's show you how I've added this to my viewer. So with actually a very small line of code, I was actually able to load that tool using this add extensions function that I've written here. Here I'm actually adding an extension called the IoT marker extension. We'll get into that a little bit further, but basically what this extension is it's just a JavaScript bundle that has some metadata and is just an executable, right? So let's take a look at that. Take a look at that extension. So here's that. Here's the activation function that we have for that extension. I'm not going to go too in-depth into how it's set up, but here's our activation function. But as you can see here, we have our select tool, which I'm just registering that. And here's that select tool, very basic, very generic. And if like I mentioned earlier, if you want, you can extend this to console log or build out your own tools, right? But let's build something more powerful. We've learned a lot of very cool features of our iTwin.js iTwin platform, such as Biz, EC SQL, and our display and presentation system. So let's build on something practical. Let's build a nice extension that kind of brings those all together. So this is not just any regular house. This is actually a smart house. So it has lots of IoT devices connected throughout. So we have some smart bulbs. We have some smart locks. We have some thermostats, the whole nine yards. So let's try to view those devices, and let's try to show some markers where they're at, and add some custom functionality. So I'm just going to uncomment out this class that I wrote, which calls this function to actually start up my marker extension. But let's take a look at this real quick. So this is that same class from before, and you can see here that I've running an EC SQL query to actually query for all the walls, the ceilings, the windows, the roof, all that good stuff. And I'm going to query for that information from my MI model. Once I've gathered a list of all those elements, I'm going to go into the display system and I'm actually going to hide all those. So I've done that here, and let's actually build this real quick and see what this looks like when this runs. I just want to mention this is written in pure JavaScript. There's no UI layer here at all. And this is going to be the same iTwin.js core APIs that you've already been familiar with. So let's go back to our Svelte viewer. And wow, look at that. Our walls are gone. Our roofs are gone. It's just the interior, right? So very cool. With a few short lines of code, we were able to do so much. So now that we've actually done this, let's uncomment out this line, which once I've done all that before, all the hiding all the elements in the model that I don't care about, let's add a decorator to our viewport. So let's take a look at this decorator. And this is also very basic. In here, I'm just creating a list of markers to display. And to do that, I'm going to do another EC SQL query. So I'm going to query my iModel for all my IoT devices, what kind of IoT device they are, where they're located in the model. And then for each one, I'm going to go ahead and create a marker for that in the viewport. So once again, driven very heavily by our presentation in ECSQL and display systems that we learned about earlier today. And let's take a look at the smart device decorator. Let me comment this out. And let's take a look at this marker. Should probably say this code. But here's our marker. And basically, what it does is it sets the image according to the type of the smart device, the IoT device. So depending on if it's a light, or if it's a speaker, or if it's a thermostat, TV, whatever. We have an icon we're showing for each one. And that's going to be the marker we're going to display in the viewport at each location. And then actually, what we're going to do is when we click on that marker, we're actually going to zoom and move to it. So let's see how this looks like in practice. So let's build again. And very quickly, you're going to see how powerful this extension API system is. All right, here we go. Wow, amazing. Just like that, we're able to locate all our IoT devices in this model and display markers across the entire, both floors. Boat and space, and look at this. If I click on I'm going to click to the washer, and wow, it's going to zoom me right to it. And I'm going to click on a light bulb, going to take me to this lamp. And there's my doors. All right, so it's going to take me to my smart locks. And wow, just like that, you can see how powerful just using our native iTwin.js core APIs are. This is JavaScript at the end of the day, right? So what's really great about this is it's write once, run everywhere. So this API, so I've written a small extension like this, right? But I can actually load this into my TypeScript viewer, into my React viewer, and let's take a look at that. So here's that same example that we saw earlier, and you can see it being loaded in the TypeScript viewer. And then here in the React viewer, I'm just gonna refresh the page for it to pick up. And wow, look at that. So same experience you get across all three UI frameworks, and it's just a very small line of code. So this is how we added it in the Svelte implementation. It's actually the same line we've actually added in the TypeScript implementation as well. So just calling extension admin add extension and adding my marker extension. And then in the viewer, we've exposed it as a separate prop for you. But all in all, very easy to consume this across all your frameworks. So I just really want to emphasize how easy it is to port your extension or add your extension in any UI framework. So this is very powerful, and we can't wait to see how you guys build your viewers, how you guys build your UI providers and extensions, and see what kind of use cases you guys bring to the field. And looking forward to that. And back to you, Caleb.
Thanks, Arun, for that awesome demo of showing the power of extensions and how they can be leveraged in real world applications. I hope that gave everybody a brief overview of how they can be used, and you're already thinking of ways to use them in your applications today. Now on the screen here, I have a handful of links that will help you continue your journey of learning about extensions and iTwin.js. Also on the screen is a link to the repository that Arun mentioned, which has many of our UI providers and extensions that we offer today. Also, feel free to reach out to us on our GitHub discussions page. The link is on the screen here, and Arun and I would love to continue the conversation with you about how you can best build your iTwin.js application. Thank you all for joining our session today. I hope you all enjoyed it and learned something. And as we said, feel free to reach out to us on GitHub if you have any further questions.